Good afternoon, students.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
आई होप यू आर डूइंग
गुड
वेल इन
आफ्टरनून
डे.
आफ्टरनून सर।
वेरी वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल इन द एग्जामिनेशन.
सर, वी
एंड
डोंट नो दैट येट बिकॉज टेट्राई मार्क्स हैव नॉट
यस
कम
सर, दे
आउट।
आर नॉट स्टिल sent on LMS. We are not able to see the result.
Yes.
That will be given by the sir, who is our course coordinator. Fine. So he will allow you to display. I mean, he will display the marks, and then you will be able to see. Fine.
Okay, sir.
Fine. But by the way, how was the paper?
Sir,
Length.
it was
Lengthy.
bit lengthy.
Sir,
Lengthy.
बहुत लेंदी था.
Sir,
Objective
like
based.
there questions, there were questions we could have done, but we did not have the time.
अच्छा.
Yeah.
So what
And
is the
so the
question?
three markers were at the end. So
Fine. So what you
yeah,
have to
that
learn
was
is
a problem.
what you have to learn from this, that you have to make a practice of it, and then you have to, I mean, you have to manage the time also. Fine. And this is not only examination, but each and every examination that you have to be taken care of, because your sessional examination as well as class test examination plus your semester end examinations. Fine. So semester end examination is of your whole syllabus and is of 3 hours duration. So you need to, I mean, practice it only, because those who are from Gujarati medium could be difficult for them to write even in a descriptive paper. This is an objective type paper. Fine. So I think it could be, but yeah, if it is an objective type as well as if it is a descriptive type, then you should practice it. Otherwise,
Sir,
yes.
sir, the
Yes.
sessionals will be of pen paper only, right?
Yet not decided.
Sir, like MCQ, can it be MCQ like this
See,
class test only?
it's totally depends on this pandemic situation. So we can't predict right now. Fine. If it is written pen and paper, that might be possible due to Corona. It may change into online mode. Fine. So it depends. We can't say. But yeah, we can prepare it for both the examinations.
But sir, if it goes online, then it has to be MCQs, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, one last doubt. We received a mail yesterday about the project work, the PowerPoint presentation thing.
Yes, that is
Sir,
Thomas Unbent.
can we know the pattern of like what we have to do in the PowerPoint presentation, like the idea design and all everything? What pattern we have to make the
I
PowerPoint
think
presentation?
today I've shared one spreadsheet to with you all people. Yes or no?
Sir.
So you have
Yes, sir.
received one notification where you will how to submit a title of your assignment. Fine. And that would be of PowerPoint presentation. Fine. So in PowerPoint presentations, at least 5 to 10 different slides that you have to add. And one more important instruction for this PPT is don't download it directly from the net, because we already have a database of it, and then it would be considered as plagiarism. Plagiarism means that similar topics. Fine. So we have a software at Nirma University through which we can identify whether it is downloaded it or not. Fine. We'll not reply in such sense, but yes, if you download it directly and if you simply change your name and if you submit, that could be again leads to a very low marks. Fine. So I request you all, I mean, you prepare this presentation by your own, type by your own. You can take the reference from the different books, even from internet also. Fine. Now, what to include it inside this presentation? First of all, you have to write the title, your name of the university on the front page. Fine. In the second page might be the contents in the form, I mean, if you have
abstract. Fine. So you can study with abstract, then you can go for the basic working of a particular component, equipment, a model. Fine. And then the topics are already shared with you people. Fine. Even
sir,
yes
sir, uske alawa koi topic le sakte hai bahar se?
Right now no.
But sir, if it's related to tetrai,
please send it to me. We'll discuss with our colleagues and course coordinator, and if they allow, they permit, we'll definitely allow you to.
So VLSI ho sakta hai?
Pardon?
VLSI technology.
VLSI technology, that is very large integrated circuits. Fine. That is a subject which is pertaining to electronics and communication engineering. Fine, no issue. I mean, if you select, but it is not relevant to our electrical engineering. Fine. So better if you want good marks, if you want better performance, better you to choose our electrical topics.
Fine. Sir, is the sensor is considered?
Pardon?
I have selected the topic of sensors, so is it okay?
First of all, you please enter the topics in the spreadsheet shared with you. Fine. Then we will discuss with you. We'll discuss okay. with you if it is not relevant. Individually, we'll discuss with the students, and then we will, because there are 66 students right now on the in the meeting, and if we discuss, then the whole lecture will be.
That means, though I've selected a topic from the list you have given, do I need to add my name or add the topic beside my name in the speech?
See, the number of topics are given that is relevant to electrical engineering. Fine. So better to choose from the list. Otherwise, you may choose from your own. But for that, again, we will discuss at our end, and then we'll come back to you. If it is relevant, then and then only we are going to allow. Otherwise, that.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So,
and
so
sir,
you,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, is it to be done in group or single student?
Right now, with the single students.
Okay. And sir, 10 slides cannot suffice like the whole topic. So can we like exceed that limit to a bit?
Say, there is no rule, I mean, to comply all such things within 10 slides or all such things. Fine. You may go for even 8 also, you may go even for 12 also. No issue.
Yes, sir.
So what is the last date of submission?
Today after the lecture. Dear students, I do not know right now, but yes, after, I think today is the last examination. Fine. So Saturday, Sunday are holiday. So please complete that session within 2 or 3 days. Fine. Most of the students already started sharing their topics. Right. So don't wait for the last date. You may start from the first date, from the day today. So once we receive for all the students, then we will discuss the issue. Okay. Okay. So I think we'll discuss much more about such things if once you submit the topics. Okay. Okay. So let me start the things related to magnetic circuits. I think last time we have. Students, please don't send the messages right now, because there are a lot of messages from you people. I welcome all the messages, but right now it could be very difficult to read and reply you within this 1 hour. Right? So first of all, you submit your topic, and if required, we will discuss. Fine. I'll share my mobile number also, and we'll make one group, WhatsApp group, and then we will discuss only technical stuffs in that. Fine. But first of all, complete your examination. Next week we will go through this group, and we will create it. Fine. Okay. So let me start. So due to examination, I'm not going to cover much more topics today, fine. But basically we will discuss few more things narrating from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed about the magnetic flux, which is the amount of magnetic flux lines of forces in the magnetic field. Second is magnetomotive force, MMF, fine. So due to MMF, the flux travels into the magnetic path made up of magnetic core material. Reluctance is the property of magnetic material to oppose the creation of magnetic flux. Fine. Then permeance. So permeance is the reciprocal of resistance, and it is a measure of these of which the flux can be set up into the material. Fine. Where the flux creation is opposed by the reluctance, and here it is, flux can be set up. So permeance. So permeance means permission to be given to the flow from the magnetic material. Fine. So this is a very important terms, reluctance and permeance. Then we have compared magnetic circuit as well as electric circuit. Fine. So magnetic circuit, which is made up of the different material. So this is core material, fine. And we also discuss the mean length of this core, fine. And this is the cross-sectional area of the core and how to set up the magnetic flux. So whenever there is a winding which is wound on the core, made up of copper material, and it is exactly kind of a solenoid where the winding is wound on a magnetic core, and if the current flows, so here, if the current flows here, fine, the magnetic flux sets up in the core, and this flux travels in the magnetic core. Fine. So this is the magnetic circuit. So magnetic circuit, where we can write the various equations. So last time we have seen about MMF, fine, reluctance. It is abbreviated as S, fine. And we have seen that the equation also L upon mu zero, mu r, fine. So where there is a permeability, a relative as well as absolute permeability of a material, fine. So this material, which is made up of iron material, and this iron material possesses higher permeability rather than the air gap. So air gap is having mu r. Mu r is the relative permeability, it is 1. So it is also possible to pass the flux through the air gap. Fine. So if there is an air gap, the flux passes and link to the another core material. So this is only possible with the flux, but not possible with the current. Fine. So if there is a conductor, and if this conductor is so if the air is provided here, fine. In such cases, the current electron will not flow from one place to the other place. Fine. So this is a true fact in electrical circuit, but in magnetic circuit, the magnetic flux is that passes, because there is a magnetic field, and it is also possible to flow the flux from the air gap also. Fine. So there is an air gap. So we will discuss today about the magnetic circuit with a different material and with a different composition. Fine. So last time we have compared. Fine. Okay. Now we will discuss a very simple magnetic circuit here. Fine. So in simple magnetic circuit, we all know the different terms, that is flux density, flux, number of turns. Fine.
So whatever the flux created here, that depends on what? Number of turns and the amount of current flows through the magnetic circuit. That is what we have discussed in the previous lecture. Okay. Now, this magnetic circuit, here you can say it is made up of a single material. Right? But it might be possible that some of the part may be made up of with a different material. Suppose if this part, let me draw with another. So suppose if this part is made up same. So here it may be made up of a different material called M1. Fine. This may also a different material. This may also a different material. And this may. So sometimes it may be possible that this magnetic circuit possesses the different magnetic material and even different length, mean length, as well as different cross-sectional area also. Fine. So whenever we consider the different length and different cross-sectional area, it looks like, just a minute, I would like to this. So whenever we have such kind of a magnetic circuit, then we can draw a magnetic circuit in a different way. Suppose if I have a magnetic circuit with a different cross-sectional area, different cross-sectional area. So this is one. Now, if I draw the another cross-sectional area, and if I draw the circuit like this, fine. So that is also possible. The third is with a different cross-sectional area and different length. Fine. So magnetic circuit made up of different shape and size of the material as well as the different material also. Fine. So here you can have the different cross-sectional area and different length. Fine. Even there is a possibility of an air gap also. Right. So here we can have a material like this. You may consider that this one is the. So it is made up of different materials. So this is number one. This is number two, number three. Here air gap is also there, is also considered as a part of the magnetic circuit. So we can consider it as a part number four. This is part number five, part number six, and part number six. Okay, fine. And if the winding is wound, yes. So here we can consider this kind of circuit as a composite magnetic circuit. Fine. So there are various parameters which may vary in the different section of this whole magnetic circuit. So here the flux will flow from this magnetic circuit. Even it will flow from the air gap, and again it will close the path here. Fine. So this is the flow of flux. Fine. But here the reluctance, the reluctance of each and every part of this composite magnetic circuit are different. Fine. So here, because we know that reluctance S is L upon mu 0 mu R A. Fine. So cross-sectional area, this is the cross-sectional area. So here the cross-sectional area is different. This is the cross-sectional area of this composite material one. This is the cross-sectional area of composite material number two. Fine. this is the cross-sectional area, right? So the different cross-sectional area means the reluctance is also going to be a different. Suppose if this is the cross-sectional area, then the reluctance is S1. Here you can consider it as S2. Here you can consider it as S3. For air gap, it is S4. And for this material, it is S5. Here it is S6. So these different reluctances, because here the length is also different of this magnetic path. Fine. So length is also different. Even the material property, fine. So material property is also different for different parts. It may be the same or it may be different. Depends on the circuit. Fine. So here permeability is also different here. Mu R is the permeability, which is also different here. Okay. Now, there are two different types of composite magnetic circuits. One is a series magnetic circuit. Series composite magnetic circuit. And the second one is parallel magnetic circuit. Right? So today we are going to discuss about series composite, and then we will discuss about parallel, and then we will try to solve few of the numericals. Fine. So basically there are two types of problems in the magnetic circuit. One is that value of flux and flux density. Value of flux and flux density is given and is to be asked to find out the MMF of the magnetic circuit, or MMF is required to be determined. Fine. And in the second case, if the applied MMF is given, if the MMF is given, and then you can find the flux and flux density of the various material or various part of the magnetic circuit. Fine. So here you can have the different problems, and according to the given, how to find out the remaining parameters that we are going to discuss today. Okay. First of all, let's have a simple magnetic circuit, which is made up of two different materials. Fine. Suppose this is material number one. This is material number two. And let's have an air gap. This is an air gap here. Okay, so we'll consider only this part. Sorry, friends, we might vanish. Okay. You may consider with a different thing. So this is the winding. Okay, so we will consider this is part one, having a length L1, cross sectional area A1, and reluctance S1. Fine. Similarly, here for this, we can consider it as S2. For air gap, we may consider it as S3. And for this material, we can consider it as S4. Fine. So here, like in resistance, we know that if resistance are connected in series, if resistances are connected in series, then it would be considered as series resistance circuit. Similarly here, the flux which is flowing in a single path, fine, and all these different materials which are connected in series, then it would be considered as a series composite circuit. So here flux is going to flow from this, fine,
And here, similarly, if you compare with the electrical circuit, we know that in series circuit, the amount of current flows, that is the same through all the different elements, right? So here flux will flow. Now, parallel circuit. In parallel circuit, suppose if there is kind of magnetic circuit, so here in this case, if the flux travels, and here if we can consider it as phi 1, then here at this point, the flux will be diverted into two different paths. One may be considered as phi 2, and here we may consider it as phi 3. Fine. So this kind of circuits here, we may consider as parallel circuit, parallel magnetic circuits, and this one is considered as series magnetic circuits. Fine. So let me start with series magnetic circuits. So here, first of all, if the series magnetic circuit is given with a different length, cross-sectional area, and different, right? So before we proceed to the series magnetic circuit, I would like to discuss with two different important terminology. One is fringing effect. And the second one is the students, am I audible? Something wrong with the internet. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Oh,
yeah, right. Because here it shows that internet connection is okay, fine. Right. So here fringing effect, and then we will discuss about the coefficient of flux. Okay, so useful flux. So it may be made up of useful flux. Second, leakage flux. So and third would be leakage coefficient. That is what we are going to discuss. Okay, so what do you mean by leakage flux? First of all, leakage flux means whenever the flux which is created through this solenoid mechanism, fine, obviously we should hope that all this flux should flow through the core material only. But sometimes what happens, these fluxes which will not travel through the hypermeability material, but it will flow through the air gap also like this sometimes, fine. And these flux are not useful. These flux are not useful for any magnetism effect, fine. So such kind of leakage flux, such kind of fluxes are known as leakage flux. And the flux which are useful for the magnetizing effect, fine. So it will travel through this material. Such kind of fluxes are known as useful flux. Useful flux, fine. So here there is a leakage coefficient, fine. And you may consider that different useful flux as well as leakage fluxes, and you can define this coefficient, fine. So what is the total flux here? So total flux is equal to useful flux plus leakage flux, fine. So here total flux, useful flux plus leakage flux. So if you know how much amount of useful flux are there and how much amount of leakage fluxes are there, fine. So you can find out the total flux, fine. So the leakage coefficient is defined as, the leakage coefficient is defined as the ratio of total flux produced to the useful flux. Total flux produced to the useful flux is called the leakage factor or leakage coefficient. So if you want to write the definition in your notebook, the leakage coefficient is defined as the ratio of total flux, ratio of total flux to the useful flux is known as leakage factor or leakage coefficient, and it is abbreviated as lambda. So lambda is total flux upon useful flux. Fine. Getting my point? All of you? So what is leakage coefficient? Okay, now let us discuss about the fringing effect. Fine. So before we discuss, we'll discuss first of all about the area. Sometimes air gap is a very important part of the magnetic circuit because air also allows to flow the flux, because air is also having different reluctances depending upon the length of the air gap. Fine. So here the length of the air gap is looking like this. Fine. So we need some air gap in the magnetic circuit path for important functions. So air gap are provided in many practical magnetic circuits, right? Like transformer or any different circuits like choke coil, right? We have seen the choke coil in the different practicals where by rotating this, we can increase or decrease the air gap or we can change the magnetic flux path, right? So this air gap has comparatively very high reluctance in comparison to the magnetic path. Fine. So it has a high reluctance compared to this. How it is, we'll discuss. Fine. So here, some of the flux derivatives from its path, it does not pass through the air gap edge. Fine. So here we can consider that if there is an air gap and if the number of flux that are passes, fine here. So here the flux travels from top to bottom through air gap, fine. But here, sometimes this flux never pass directly from one material to air gap and to the other material, but it diverts sometimes. So it will be because there is no fixed path in the air gap, fine. So it might be possible due to air gap, the flux travels as a leakage flux, and might be possible that the same flux, leakage flux, again it is going to be again linked to the another magnetic material. So here you can say the cross-sectional area of this material and the cross-sectional, because this effect is nothing but it is known as fringing effect. So in fringing effect, you can say the cross-sectional area of the fringing effect, because again it is a flux path, fine. So here this fringing effect that increases the cross-sectional area, fine. And this increase in cross-sectional area, the importance of providing the air gap into the magnetic circuit is the saturation. Sometimes it is also possible whenever we increase the amount of current, I mean, if we increase the intensity of the magnetic flux H, fine, and the flux density will increase up to certain instant, but after some times it goes into the saturation, fine. So if you increase H again, fine. This is H and this is B. So again, if you increase this intensity after a certain point, fine, of the magnetic flux, then core will be saturated. So the core will be saturated means
there is a maximum capacity of the flux to flow from this. Fine, even if we increase the current and if we increase the intensity of the material. So that could not be fine. But by providing this air gap, again, we can increase the intensity and we can stop saturating this core material, because if the core material is saturated, then it will not perform well as a magnetic circuit, right? So by providing this air gap, we can avoid the saturation of the magnetic material which is used for the magnetic circuit. So we can avoid such saturation effect by providing this air gap, fine? Okay, so here we can increase in the lengthwise, or we can increase and decrease cross section, because if we increase the length of the air gap, fine, this area, so if you increase the length of air gap, fine, might be the cross-sectional area is looking like this. And if you decrease the length of air gap like this, right, it might be possible that the cross-sectional area is going to change. Fine. So there are different effects. In some applications, this air gap is fixed, like a rotating electrical machines. Right. So rotor is there, and fixed amount of air gap is there, and then there is a stator. So rotor and stator are there in the rotating electrical machines. Right. So this is a stator. This part is rotor. Rotor is a rotating part, and in between there is an air gap is provided. Right. So here stator is also a magnetic circuit, rotor is also a magnetic circuit. And the flux which is produced by stator, magnetic field or electromagnetic field, travels through air gap and then it. So, sorry, this is an example of air gap. Sorry. Okay. So air gap is required sometimes, but due to that, there is a fringing effect, and according to that, the cross-sectional area of the air gap is changed. I mean, the magnetic flux path is changed, right? And such effect is known as fringing effect. Okay. So here we can write the different equations. Here we can write the different equations for the reluctances. Okay. So, first of all, we can write the equation of reluctance for this series magnetic composite circuit. So S is equal to S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus S4, because there are four different parts. Or we can write in a different way, L1 upon μ0, μr1, because μr1 is of material 1, μ0 is absolute permeability, and cross-sectional area U1, plus L2 upon μ0, μr2 into A2, plus L3 upon μ0, μr3 into A3, plus L4 upon μ0, μr4 into A4. So we can write an expression of S. Okay. Are you with me, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are trying to derive an expression of series composite circuits. Fine. So let me erase this. We are going to write a few more equations from this. Okay. So here, can we write an expression total NNS. Yes or no? Yes, we can write. What is the equation of total MMF? Yesterday we have derived. That is flux into reluctance. Flux into reluctance. We can say MMF is equal to phi into S. Or S is equal to MMF of phi. That is what study we have discussed. Okay. So here we know that the flux is phi. So we can write flux phi here, and then we can write a reluctance L1 upon mu 0 mu r a 1 plus. I will not write all these four terms fine here. Okay, but you can write L2 upon mu 0 mu r 2 a. Now, if the part 3 is an air gap, for air gap mu r is 1, right? So here you can write for part 3 mu 0 only, because mu r 3 is a air gap permeability and it is equal to 1. So here you may omit, right? No issue. Now we can write this expression in the form of MMF, total MMF, right? And we know that flux, what is flux density? Flux density B is equal to, that is the flux passing per unit area, flux passing per unit area. So this is flux density, and the unit is Weber per meter square, or we can say it is Tesla. Fine. So what is flux density? The flux density is defined as the flux passing per unit area. Flux passing per unit area. Fine. So here we can replace this phi and this a. So here if we write phi here and phi here, then with the help of this phi by a, because flux is in series circuit, phi is same. Fine. We cannot write phi 1, phi 2, phi 3 like this. Fine. Because phi's are the same in series circuit. So here phi upon a1, phi upon a2, we can replace it with b. Fine. So here we can write b1, because phi is constant or same, but a1, a2, that cross-sectional area are different. So we may have different flux density, that is b1. Fine. Upon mu 0 mu r 1, or we can say we are wrong, into L1 plus B2 upon mu 0 mu r 2 into, or we can write it L2 here also. Is that no? So this way we can write the different equations, and then we can also write the another expression which is an important in the form of H. H is the intensity, fine. So we know that H is equal to, or B is equal to, we can write B is equal to, B is equal to mu 0 mu r H, or we can write H is equal to B upon mu 0 mu r, fine. So here B upon mu 0 mu r will be replaced with H. H is the field intensity, magnetic field intensity. So here we can write H1, by replacing this term, we can write H1 into L1 plus H2 into L2. And similarly, we can write for the other terms also. So MMF is written in the form of intensity, in the form of flux density, in the form of flux, right? So we can write these different equations, and we can derive these different equations in the form of intensity also. So if you know the intensity and if you know the length, you can also get the value of MMF, fine. So if the value of flux and flux densities are given, you can find the MMF with respect to intensity in the form of length also. And we know that MMF is Ni, yesterday we have seen, right, in the circuit, if the current amount of current flows in, the number of turns will generate the MMF magnetomotive force in the circuit, right? So total MVA turns or MMF required for a series magnetic circuit can be found with these four different equations, right? Okay, so this is series magnetic circuit. Okay, so how to calculate ampere turns? Ampere turns is what? This is ampere turns. Yesterday I used this word. N is the number of turns and I is the ampere. So here we can also consider as ampere turns, AT. Fine. So what would be the first process to find out the ampere turns? First of all, if the value of flux is given, fine, we can find. Okay, let me erase. If the value of flux is given, we can find the B cross, I mean flux density using phi. So the equation becomes B is equal to phi by A. So with the help of this equation, we can find if the flux is given, we can find the flux density, or if the flux density is given, we can find the fluxes. Fine. For second equation is to find out H. Fine. So find H for each part, and then we can use H is equal to B upon mu zero mu r equation, and then we can find from this flux density, we can find H also. Fine. If the relative permeability and absolute permeability is same for all the materials, but relative permeability is different for different materials. So high permeability material is good if we use, because there are less leakage fluxes in high permeability. Okay. So third step is, if we know the L, or we can measure the length of magnetic circuit, or if it is given, then with the help of ampere turn AT, or last time we have written MMF. MF is equal to AT is equal to, if there are four different composite materials, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So H1 is different, L1 plus H2 L2 plus H3 L3 plus H4 L4. So these are the steps from flux and flux density. You can calculate the MMF or ampere turns, total ampere turns required for the magnetic circuit. Fine. I hope this is clear to all. And any more questions if you have? Otherwise, we may stop here today because there is an examination after 4:15. Any more question?
No, sir.
No, sir. So I hope all of you will submit the term assignment title and PPT. First of all, submit the title, and once we approve, then we'll start preparing the presentation also. Right? Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Yeah. You may leave. Thank you.